how does the police department get to decide if I am or am not a church? I mean, you know, we got surveillance on us, you know? Look at this back here. Doesn't matter to me. We'll see what the judge says. Because as far as I'm concerned, the police department is not going to define me as if I'm spiritual or not spiritual, or what I'm doing here or not doing here. You know, do I have a Bible in here? Do I have a Quran in here? Do I have a Holy Bibi in here? You know, do I have the books of Buddha in here, or some yoga books or Hindu books? It's none of their business. You know, it's nobody's business. What I do in the morning, what I do in the evening, I'm a nocturnal person. I mean, here it is, a couple minutes after 12, I just got up a little while ago. Usually I get up when my body wakes me up. You know, unless I really have to do something, I'm sleeping in the morning because I'm up all night. I'm a nocturnal person. These people who are flocking to my temple, they're nocturnal people too. I encourage it. These are the people I communicate with late at night on Facebook. These are the people who are posting at 2 in the morning. You know, now they're within driving distance of me, and now they're coming here. The police harassment and intimidation really got serious this week. It's like the fourth week in a row. The police showed up around 1 o'clock. And first, they just kind of circled the area. I guess they were calling in, converging on the area. A couple of them posted up on this street, a couple of them posted up on that street, and they aggressively started giving out tickets. One guy, you can see him. Someone told him that the police were outside and he's parked in a bad spot. I mean, we went looking for him and found whose car it was. And he goes outside, he gets in his car, he's getting ready to drive away. And the police car sees, police see him and speed up to him like this, side by side, tells him don't move. And then writes him a ticket. And those tickets are $274. And you know, those meters are only supposed to be good from 8 in the morning, I think it is, until 5 p.m. So I'm not even sure if that's even a valid ticket after 5 p.m., but the police are like really, really harassing my congregation. Now, we opened to pretty good fanfare. I mean, come on, this is a depressed city. Trenton, New Jersey, urban blight. This is an urban tax zone because they're trying to encourage business, and I came here and this is how the police department treat me. We haven't had any problems, you know, no more problems than a Burger King or a Big Mac, I mean a McDonald's. I mean, we're chilling here. Like that night, there's about 30 people here minding our own business, and like I said, please show up. At one point, if you look, detective motions for me to come over. I started not to go, but anyway, I go. I stick my head in the window, and he starts telling me that, you know, hey, you know, we don't really want to do this, but blah, 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 blah. You got to close. It's after 11. I said, no, I don't have to close, and I'm not going to close. I said, you see that sign I put up in there? Open. I'm open 24 hours now. I'm not closing. And I walked away. Of course, he motioned for me to come back. I came inside, started looking out the window, started watching, and at one point, about five or six of them got out of the car, came up to the door, knocking on the door, and they were pacing back and forth, looking through the windows, but we just didn't open the door. As soon as they moved away from the door, of course, we opened the door and let other people in. But I did notice they pulled up and shined their flashlight on my van. I knew they were going to tow it. Actually, at one point, I jumped in the van, and I was going to move it. But I said, you know, as soon as I try to move it, they're just going to pull me over and give me tickets, too. So just sat back and watched them do it. Now, the police, I have no idea who's put them up to this, but we know how police officers are. They're like meatheads, man. They do what they're told, you know. They follow the rules, or they try to follow rules, we'll put it that way. So somebody put the police officers up to it. Maybe one of the lieutenants put the police officers up to it, but they're wrong. The very first right in the Bill of Rights says you have a right to assemble. That's what we're doing, we're assembling.
So the place looks kind of bare with the weed mobile towed away. Now, I want to show you now. Look at these signs. You know? Pretty sure these meters are until 5 o'clock. I don't know about these signs. Now, as far as I'm concerned, I don't care how much police harassment comes my way. I'm not gonna change my opinion. My opinion is, I open this place as a temple, as a sanctuary, and I'm gonna keep it open. I filed this lawsuit. We'll see what happens. I don't know. I have no idea what the judge and how the judge is going to rule, but I have no intention of closing down.